Hey guys, Ms. Gerard here. Just wanted to do a real quick tutorial on suction regulators. So you may see these in the clinical setting. You may see these at the sim lab or in the NEC or the HSC, but I wanted to again give you guys a brief overview of how to use them and what they may look like. So here are two examples of suction regulators. They're both suction regulators. They're just from different brands. So I'm gonna quickly go over what some of these mean and how to use them. Please keep in mind that when you are using a suction regulator in a simulation or at a clinical site, they may be a different shape, color, or have different functions. If you're unsure, be sure to check with your clinical instructor or the nurse that you're precepting with that day. So we'll start with this one here. So you have REG, line, and off. So, and then you've got this dial here. So you can spin this dial and nothing happens until you turn it on. I also want you to take note of the pressure inside the regulator. So you've got your pressure dial. Oftentimes you'll see that they've asked you to set suction to low intermittent or low continuous or 120 millimeters of mercury. That's what the MMHG stands for. So you may have an order for suction continuous at 120 millimeters mercury. So let's go with that, and we are going to make that happen for our patients. So first things first, we're going to spin this dial to reg, so REG, and that just means that it's going to provide adjustable continuous vacuum suction, okay? So for this particular device, you always want to have a piece of tubing connected to the device. If you don't, it just provides suction directly from the regulator. But always keep in mind, you never, ever, ever want to hook up suction that you're going to use on a patient or a mess and hook it directly to the regulator. You always must have a secondary collection device. You need a middleman. Everyone needs a good middleman. So you may see a canister such as this, something smaller, something larger, but you must always connect your suction regulator directly to a middleman before you connect tubing to a patient. So we're gonna do that now. So we're connecting our suction that's going to the canister to the regulator. So now we want to turn the dial right and left until the ticker lands on 120, because that's what our order is set at. And you can hear that it's quite loud sometimes, and it does suction. It's okay if the dial spins a little bit once you've connected it to suction. You just want to make sure that you've got the dial where you need it to go. So we're going to have the suction set up. So let's say that we are now sucking directly to our chest tube or our pleurovac, our suction canister, whatever we've been ordered to regulate. And we're going to spin the dial until we can get the needle at 120. There you go. And it's okay if it sways a little bit one way or another, but you want to keep it so that it's mostly sitting where it's been ordered, okay? And if you have a specific order to set it at 120 or 80 or 30 and your regulator is not working correctly or it's not enabling you to get the dial where you need it, be sure to check with your nurse or your instructor and try and get a hold of a regulator that does work, because you want to be sure that you're suctioning at an appropriate level for your patient per your physician's orders. Okay, so we're going to turn this off and we're going to continue kind of talking about it. So this particular regulator, we already talked about, has an off A reg, so regular regulator, provides adjustable continuous suction. And then over here, you'll see it says line. Line on this particular model stands for maximum continuous vacuum. So let's say you just need to get powerful suction right here, right now for an emergency, you would put it on line. So you see how it goes from off to full vacuum immediately. Versus regulator or reg, where we had already spun the dial to get it where we needed it. Remember? All right. So we've kind of touched base on this model. Let's check out this other model. Again, we want to hook up our middleman here. Never, ever, ever suction directly from the regulator to your patient. Because if you do, whatever you're suctioning up, be it water or blood or sputum, it will go directly from the regulator into the wall. That's gross. And then it can get back in the system and it can actually cause growth of bacteria and fungus and provide infection risks for anyone else in the system that's using that line of suction. So always, always, always be sure to have a middleman between your regulator and whatever you're sucking up. Okay, so we'll go ahead and hook up our middleman here. We've got our canister attached. And let's talk about the canister really quickly here. Again, your canister may look a little bit different, but I want to touch base on the options. Most canisters have similar options. There will always be a specific port for your suction, for your vacuum. It's typically in the center, but regardless, it will have a label that either says suction, vacuum, regulator, port, etc. This is very important to hook your suction regulator directly to this port because the lid has a filter. So this provides anything that's in the canister from being sucked up through this port, okay? Then you've got a variety of other size ports. This one says tandem, this one says patient. Again, they may be labeled differently, they may look a little bit different, but any of the regulator tubes that you don't want to use, you'll just be sure to cap off. Sometimes they'll have a small attachment like this, you can use it, you don't have to, just go by your facility's policies. Okay, so for our example today, we're going to hook our suction up to the vacuum port and we're going to prepare to suction our patient. Let's look at this regulator briefly. So unlike the red one next to it, and again, they may be different colors, they may look different, they may be different shapes. Just be sure to accustom yourself with what you're using before you start to use it on a patient, okay? So this one has three sections as well. It has an off, it has an INT, and a reg. So for this particular model, REG, reg, stands for the same thing that the other one did. It provides continuous adjustable vacuum suctioning. And INT provides intermittent adjustable suctioning. So it will auto-regulate itself to go off, and then on, and then back off, and then on. And again, once it's on, you'll set it to the pressure that you would like it to be set at or that your doctor's orders suggested it be set at or ordered you to set at. So for our example today, we're gonna have it on reg and we're gonna leave it at 200, although again, I can change it. So again, if your order says low intermittent, on this particular regulator, it doesn't say low, medium or high, it just has a green, yellow, orange, and red section. So it may not look the same, the colors may be different, just keep in mind of the pressure values. If unsure, please, please, please clarify your orders with your physician. So for this particular example, we're gonna set it right around 60, we want low continuous suction for this particular patient. So we've got our middleman hooked up safely, so we're not going to suck anything into the wall. Then I've got my extra suction tubing, and I'll use this to attach to a yonker or any other device that we're going to use to suction whatever we're suctioning. So I've connected it to the open port. You always want to test it. Notice the sound changes because you're occluding the vacuum. You can also see that when I occlude the suction vacuum, the pressure increases. Okay? So we've got our suction turned on. I'm going to attach my yonker. Again, you can hear that the suction is working. And I am going to suction just a little bit of fluid from the canister. You can see that the suction has gone through the tubing a little bit and it's made its way down here into the canister. We're going to turn the suction off briefly, and I'm going to show you guys with our trach suction tubing. So when you're suctioning a trach, you have this particular tubing or something that looks like it. On your catheter tubing here, it has the port that you would insert into the suction tubing. And then you have this hole right here that you will occlude with your thumb to provide suction to the holes that are at the tip of your suction catheter. So when you are suctioning your patient, we'll do a quick demonstration here. So let's say that this is my patient and I'm suctioning. I want to occlude this hole so that all the suction pressure is now coming from the holes at the base of this catheter. And notice if I let go of that hole on top, the suction is now coming from here. And that's just a really quick overview of how to use our suction regulators. Thanks for watching.